Brittany Pyatt, and today I'll be talking to you about my major, which is environmental science with geology, and why I would be a great fit for the legalization of marijuana group. First of all, to understand what environmental science is, we first have to know what constitutes as the environment. According to Christensen and Leach, which are the authors of my environmental science book, the environment is all the physical, chemical, and biological factors and processes that determine the growth and survival of an organism or a community of organisms. So therefore, environmental science is just the study of the environment. Some of the topics and issues that environmental science deals with are things like sustainability. Sustainability is probably the biggest one that we look at, and that just means that we look at ways to meet the needs of the present generation without compromising the needs for the future generation and their ability to get those needs. That also comes from Christensen and Leach. When talking about sustainability, my professor, Dr. Kumler, describes it as a nested system between the environment, the social aspect, and the economic aspect. And that can be seen in a diagram like this. This shows that the environment is the biggest piece. It's what we need to have anything. From the environment, we can get the social aspect. We can get the people and any organisms. Without the social aspect, we wouldn't have the economy. So each of the bigger things is what we need for the smaller. Another topic that we look at are ecosystems, and that's just where the organisms live and how we can keep them living there without destroying their habitats. Conservation is also a big issue that we look at, and the biggest conservation thing that we look at are saving energy. Whether that's in a building or outside, we like to get the most energy for the least amount of cost and the least harm for the environment. Some of the epistemologies that environmental science deals with is modernism, and that just means that we look at the real objective world that we can study. And based off of the modernism, we are positivists, which means that we use a scientific method. We quantify things. And in geology, we use rational choice because geology itself is one big theory, so we're using all these theories to make a bigger theory. And that comes from REPCO of 2012. And geology is just the study of the earth, and as Dr. McNaught, my professor, explains it, it's just the understanding of how the earth works and changes and how it has changed over time. Some of the strengths that my major has to offer for the marijuana group are that I can tell my group what the conditions for the optimal growth of marijuana is, as seen in this picture, and I can also tell my group the effects of marijuana on the environment, whether they're good or bad, or whether it takes up too much water, which has been a big controversy in marijuana. One other strength that I can bring to my group is that I can tell the characteristics of the roots and soil, and that has a lot to do with organisms in the ground. And different soils are going to help or hurt the plant whenever it's growing. Like, if there's too much silt, it probably won't be able to grow, but if there's a lot of sand or clay, it just depends on the composition of the soil. Some of the limitations that my major has, according to REPCO, is that there may be other reasons or ways that things happen. So just because I think I see a correlation with something based off of my major, that might not be the actual reason that that's happening. Some other limitations that we have are, based off of my major, I don't know the psychological and physical effects that marijuana has on people. And I don't know if those effects cause an addiction and how to help that addiction. And the last thing that my major doesn't allow me to know are the economical factors, like how much to sell the marijuana for, if we should tax it, and all of the political aspects of it. And those are my reports.